Yes, sir.
Fantastic. So then I'll get started. My name is Mike Donnarumma, and I'm with M2 Media Group. And tonight I'm joining Christy Cooper and Scott Littmer. Christy's from Girl Scouts Historic Georgia. Scott is from Trophy Nut Company. And we are all going to bring you the 2016 Fall Product Program Training. I am very excited to bring you this program. This is our second year of working with M2 Media Group and Trophy Nut Company. And before we even get started, the council had a banner year last year. Increases across the board and great success. So as far as today's agenda, we will talk about a little bit of welcome and introductions, which I just did. We'll go through the fall product program. I'll talk about the girl participation in person and talk a little bit about the rewards the girls can earn. Then we'll do some volunteer management, the troop level login, and all of the things associated with that. And then I'll turn it back over to Christy for important dates and council details, and we'll follow that up with some questions as we go along. So as we get started, I'd like to first and foremost say thank you, because without all of you at the troop level, and some of you might even be troop and service unit level, we appreciate your time, energy, and efforts. We could not do this program without you. The support that you give the girls in this program generates lots of funds and lots of learning experiences in this program, and these are skills that will last the girls a lifetime. So the most important part to remember is that sometimes you have to count out the materials or collect the materials or collect orders and do some of the harder work in the program. But remember that this program generates a great learning experience for the girls and generates funds that will eventually turn into more program and more fun activities that the girls can do. And I always like to share, many times the girls are earning money to do things that they might not have been able to do otherwise. Keep that in mind as you think about this program and the importance of it and the importance of the cookie program. So our goals today is, as a company and a council, we wanted to provide a money-earning activity that was fun, easy, made it more profitable for your troops, but at the same time, we wanted to make it beneficial to girls and troops from providing skills and helping defray costs. And how many of you are either new troop leaders and remember the day when you were a troop leader and remember that the first time you were a troop leader, you probably had to reach in your pocket and collect and spend money to run those first few meetings. This is a great way, this program in the fall is a great way to help all troop leaders and especially new troop leaders earn some money so that they can use that money to start their campaign prior to the cookie program. So this is a great way to start the program with funds in your troop, and we've made it easier than ever before. Your role is to share the benefits of the program with the parents and girls. We want you to make sure that the girls and parents know that this is a valuable program. If you endorse the program and you say to parents, hey parents, this is easy, this is fun, this is something we should do, they will do it. So please encourage their participation. We want you to set goals for the girls and for the parents to let them know that setting goals will always help you get a better result in any program you participate in. So think about the things you want to do with the money, set your goals, and then motivate the girls throughout the program so that we have the ability to keep the girls constantly informed, keep parents constantly informed by communicating those details, and what we'll get is the result we're looking for. And it's very exciting when you set goals and actually achieve them. We also, at the end of the campaign, want you to, well, not the end of the campaign, but in the middle and then the end of the campaign, we want you to distribute the products and we want you to distribute the rewards, because what we like to remind girls is that hard work generates rewards, and that's part of the learning in this program. Troop proceeds we've made simpler than ever before. You will see that everything I talk about today will make this program easier than the past. And this program was pretty easy to start with, but the first one is we did a straight $1.25 profit across the board. So any nut and candy item, any troop-to-troop donation, anything you sell on the order card, anything you sell online is $1.25 troop proceeds. And that is a really, really high troop proceeds. Many councils offer less than a dollar or sometimes a dollar. You are offering a much higher troop proceeds than many of the councils that run this program. In addition, we up the magazine portion to give $2 for every magazine subscription. So it's a very simple calculation. Number of net items times $1.25, number of magazines times $2. That combination will make true proceeds much easier than ever before. You don't have to remember what was online, offline, it doesn't matter. Online or offline, $1.25 for nut and candy item, $1.25 troop donation, and $2 for every magazine. The program also this year has a white tiger and three themes that we have three different patches that fit together to form a diamond, and that's Dare to Dazzle, Do the Bright Thing, and hashtag Sparkle. And when you earn all three of them, it forms a diamond to generate excitement in the program. And I'll talk in a few minutes about what you have to do to earn those. Now, there are two ways to participate in this program. We have the in-person using the nut order card, and then we have the online portion, which this council did an outstanding job with the online portion of the program. But even though I like and get excited about the online portion of the program, I like to remind everyone that the nut order card portion of the program is a very valuable learning experience. In the world where we constantly are looking at our devices, teaching girls to go up to someone, do an in-person interaction, ask them to buy something, tell them about the cool things they're going to do with the money, and then generating that in-person sales pitch is a very valuable learning experience. Girls will use that in their first job interview, or they will use that when they get to their first job when they're trying to sell their boss on a great idea. So this is a really great learning experience, so we don't want to minimize the in-person interaction, but any good business has a great in-person interaction and also a great online experience. So the first thing I'll cover is the in-person experience. Before I do that, I want to remind everybody that we made a change to the program this year. So last year we had magazine catalogs and order forms where you can place magazine orders in person. This year, to make the program easier for all of you, and because most of our customers went online anyway, is that the magazine portion of the program will be online only this year. And what that means is there will be no more in-person for magazines. The only way to place your magazines is online, so make sure you send emails out to your family and friends if they want magazines. The number of magazines we sold on from a catalog on order forms last year dwindled to such a low number that we decided to remove it and make the program much easier for all of the volunteers and the parents and girls to run. The in-person experience is the nut order card, though, and that we have a delicious set of items to choose from. The items, there's lots of new items this year. There's lots of gift items. We have the troop back again. I'll cover a few things. First and foremost, the mint trefoils we have in a Girl Scout jewelry box tin. We have a s'mores mix. You've been hearing lots of cool things about s'mores products. This year in a plastic mason jar, we have the s'mores mix, which is a chocolate-covered graham cracker and a white chocolate-covered marshmallow. We also have, new this year, is dark chocolate sea-salted almonds and lots of other great gifts and items to choose from. You'll notice that there are 15 items on the nut order card plus the troop, which makes 16 choices for your customers to purchase and buy, and the girls will deliver these products, and the money is collected up front for these purchases. So the sales happen in person up front, so you go out, sell in person, collect the money, and then we will distribute the product later on to our customers. But this product lineup is awesome. It's got so many things to choose from. You can go check it out online, but make sure you look at your nut order card and come up with a goal for your in-person nut sales. A few reminders. We will in a few minutes talk about the orders placed online that will automatically translate. This year, any of your nut order card orders get entered into the system, but we don't enter any of the online orders onto that order card. Parents will only enter the in-person order card sales into the M2OS, which I'll talk about in a couple minutes. Remember that online, your nut promises are paid by a credit card, which I will remind you in a few minutes. We have nutrition information that can be found on the homepage and also on the storefront online. So you could check that out either by going to the store and clicking on the product. And then I will talk to you a little bit about in a couple minutes on how to find your delivery tickets and all the other cool stuff as we go through the program. So again, remember, your nut and chocolate products are placed in person. We collect the money up front. We then enter that information into the system, and then we will get our delivery a little bit later on. Rewards this year are pictured on the back of the Nut Order card, and rewards are also pictured online. You will notice that we have magazine rewards that are specific for the magazine program. We have Nut and Candy rewards that are specific for the Nut and Candy program, and we also have rewards that are common between both. We have our personalized patch again this year, which I'll get into in a few minutes, plus we have patches for sending out 15 emails and selling items on both sides. All of these are pictured on your Nut Order card. Have the girls check the box that they are interested in, and then the online system will make sure that if you earn that item, it will ask parents to go in and make their selections. So this is a way to make sure everybody understands all the rewards, but remember again that the rewards are also online this year for everybody to see. Now let's talk about the girls' online experience. So many of you remember from last year, because we had such great participation, many of you remember all of the cool avatars you got to make. This year we added a number of new features. We added more hairstyles, we added more shoe types, we added cowboy boots and different types of tennis shoes, and we added a tiara and sunglasses on your head and all kinds of great choices to create our avatar. So this year, to get started, the girls are going to land on their landing page. The landing page is going to say to log in or register. If you logged in the past, you can find your password if you forgot it, or if you haven't and you're new to the program, you can register an account. And this is also, you'll notice at the bottom, volunteers, all of your troop volunteers, we have a little button for you now too, so that on the landing page, you know where to get to the volunteer section, and I'm going to cover that in a few minutes. First thing you'll do is you'll present your zip code. The reason we did that is that the zip code validates to make sure you're in the right place. We want to make sure every girl is in the right part or the right program, so you'll be asked for your zip code. Once you enter your zip code, it will ask you to set up your campaign by creating your name and your password. This year, we've improved the password security, so you have to actually create a more stringent password. You can't do 1, 2, 3, 4 anymore. You have to do a capital letter and you have to do a number. That way we keep everyone's data protected, and you then sign up and register your account. Once you register your account, you will choose your troop number, or if you don't see your troop number in the list of troops, you'll click the box that says, I don't know or see my troop or group number. If you do that, what's great about that is the council will then have the ability to find out what troop that girl is in and make sure she gets put in the right troop. This year, you'll also, after you choose your troop number or you say, I don't see my troop number, the name is there, so Susie Jones, you'll choose Susie Jones. And what will happen is it will have Susie Jones' first and last name. Last year, we let the parents change the name in case she wanted to have a nickname. But this year, we are no longer allowing parents to change the database name, so whatever name is in there, but we have a separate field so that if Susie wants to go by a nickname, she can enter that nickname in that field. So we have a nice way to make sure the girls can go by their nickname and also make sure the data doesn't get changed. The last thing is to answer the questions on what does being a Girl Scout mean to you and what are you going to do with the money earned. And I always talk about this because it's very important to get the girls to type in to the system what they're going to do with the money earned, because Uncle Mike, and that's me, loves when his niece Kira, and that's my niece in Long Island, New York, who's a Girl Scout, loves when my niece Kira participates in these programs, and he loves nuts and chocolates, and Uncle Mike loves his magazines, but what he loves more than anything else is helping his niece get to her goal of maybe going to camp or going to visit Juliet Lowe's birthplace or maybe going to sleep with the sharks at the aquarium. So make sure the girls are taking the time to set up their dashboard and what they're going to do with the money. Then you get to create your avatar, and our avatar is the most fun thing you get to create. It follows you through the program. You'll notice that we have a tiara, sunglasses on your head, cowboy boots, we have a wheelchair. Last year, there were 24 girls in our program that chose the wheelchair as their avatar, and we even have options like a bald head and other options, and we had girls choose those options this year, and there's over 3 billion unique avatars that you can create in the program. That's your likeness that will follow you through it, and I have an avatar, and all the council people have avatars. It's a fun way to get in on the fun. This year, our avatar will speak. So our avatar will talk to the girls and parents, and then the avatar will talk to Uncle Mike. This year, the avatar will tell you all the fun things you'll get to do, and also It will tell Uncle Mike the fun, cool things that participating in this program will help. And then next year, so this year we have a voice that is specific and it will share a specific message. Next year, the girls will even be able to upload their own voice into the program. So that's not for this year, but for next year, you have something to look forward to. The avatar can earn virtual rewards as you go through the program by taking various actions in the system, and this is a fun way to go check out all the rewards you earned at the end. Personalize your campaign. You can upload a photo or upload a video, and you can decorate the photo. And what we've learned over the last couple of years is that when you upload a photo or video, you increase your sales. Girls who upload a photo increase their sales by 50%. Girls that upload a video increase their sales by 108%. So recommend that the girls take the time to upload and personalize their storefront because they get better results. We also show the girls what their personalized patch looks like, which is in the right of the screen, and it will show you exactly what your Ally Sparkles patch looks like so that you know exactly what you're getting when you get to the goal level. Once you've created your storefront and you've sent out your 15 emails, we also want you to share on social media. If you share on Facebook or one of the social media posts, you increase your sales by 27%. And we like a very simple social media share generating that kind of additional income. We want to recommend that all girls share on social media with their parents. This allows a great way to make sure you increase your sales. Now remember, girls and parents are logging in together, so when they share on social media, it should be parents' social media account that they're sharing on because parents and girls go through this process together. Personalized patches. You remember from last year, there was a few people waiting a little bit longer for their patches. This year, we put the personalized patch address into the system so that when you get here, you enter your address, you can pick your first name, your nickname, or your initials for your personalized patch. And that way, more people will get their patches faster than ever before. The personalized patch this year looks like this, Juliet Sparkles. You will see that the patch is earned by selling 6 magazines and 24 nut items and by sending 15 emails. So you still have to sell your 6 magazines, you still have to sell your 24 nut items, and you send 15 emails, you can earn this patch for the fall. It's very exciting. Lots of girls earned that patch last year, and they worked very hard to get it. So we're coming back with it again, and in a little while, I'm going to tell you about the fun of maybe even a second personalized patch. Participant headquarters, this is where you go when you're completed. You can visit your magazine store, visit your nut store. You can see the emails you sent. You could manage your paper orders, which I'll tell you about in a minute. You can check out your sales reports. You can see all the goals that you've set and how close you are. One of my favorite new things is by the business card you can print off the system. So when you're done creating your storefront, you can print a little business card that will have your magazine store and your nut store and a special code. The business card will have your avatar on it. You cut this in 8, and then you can hand these around town and give them to your family and friends, and then they can go shop your store. So if you're not ready to, if your customer is not ready to buy something right now, okay, no problem. I have a business card I'd like to leave behind, and that way you can place your order and do that in the comfort of your home. The rewards this year are also listed online. You will notice they are neater and cleaner than ever before. It will show you what patches you earn. Those are last year's patches, just as an example. But what you'll see is those patches are earned. It'll tell you what you have to do to earn them. It'll show you what you have to do to sell it. And when you earn those rewards, there will be a little banner that says earned. And if there's something that requires a choice, it will tell you that an action is required. So we will make it easier than ever before, and the council will be able to send messages out to people who didn't make their choices. So we want to make sure that we've given everybody tools to make their choices and pick the rewards they want. When you visit your room, what's really cool is you can see all your virtual rewards that you've earned. You can get a pet tiger in your room, and you can also see all of the girls in their group photo. And you can see, in addition to that, you can see the troop leader and the troop product managers avatars as well. We asked the girls what they liked about visiting their room, and they told us it was mostly so that they could see their troop leader and their troop product manager's avatar. So we want the troop leaders to get in on the fun. Make sure you create your avatar and tell the girls, do you want to see my avatar? Log in and participate in the program, and then you can see my avatar too. So it's a great way to get the girls excited about participating. This is something we started last year, and it was very successful, so we're going to continue with it. But I remind all the troop product managers and all the troop leaders on the phone that it's still something that you have the ability to edit and enter if the parents don't. So at the parents at the end of the program, when they're finished selling their nut order card orders, they can enter all of the items along the bottom of the nut order card in the system so that they could save you time and effort. But that does not mean that you are not to check them. We still want troop product managers and troop leaders to double check the orders to make sure the orders are correct. And if someone can't get it in, the troop will have access to be able to enter it for them. And if they have to edit it or change it or delete it, the troops will have access after the parents. So the parents will have access first. We will lock the parents out. Troops will have access to edit, double check, and enter anybody's orders who haven't been in. We will then lock them, the troops, out. Once the troops are locked out, service units will be able to edit, verify, and enter anybody's order that hasn't gotten entered in yet. And then the council will have access the whole time. So if you're having trouble, contact the council. They will help you get the order in. This is a way to help you at the troop level get the parents to help enter the orders, but you still need to double check it. You still need to make sure the order is correct, and they need to be entered into the system so that we can validate and correct process the correct rewards and the correct order that gets delivered. Reports this year, we have them broken out by all different categories: sales, magazines, nuts, paper, online Nut Girl delivered. And this year, troops will be able to log all the way down to the end customer. If you remember last year and you were trying to help Susie find out who bought something, you couldn't do that because you couldn't get all the way down to the level of customer. Now the troops and the service units will have information all the way down to the supporter, and that's the Uncle Mikes and Grandmas of the world. And you'll be able to see exactly what Uncle Mike and Grandma bought if girls are having trouble figuring that out. The storefronts, magazines, and the nut storefront, you will notice, are separate. They have a video, they have a photo or an avatar, they have a goal chart, they have your message that we created earlier. And this year, we got all of those Time Inc. titles back. So if you remember last year, we didn't have Time Magazine, Sports Illustrated, we didn't have People, and we didn't have Real Simple. So we were missing some titles that are now back in the program. And we also have new subscription kits, which are educational subscription kits that you can order, and every month a subscription will show up that's educational in nature as a gift or to buy for someone you love. It's a great new item on the magazine storefront. Remembering again, nuts and magazines can both be purchased online. Magazines can only be purchased online, whereas nuts has the nut order card where you can place offline as well. When you do buy nuts online, you have two choices. You have the ability to save the shipping cost and coordinate with parents and guardian for the pickup of the product, or you have the convenience of paying by credit card and having it shipped. Remember, in your council, whether you choose save the shipping cost or have it shipped directly, both are paid for online at purchase with a credit card. On the save shipping cost, the girls will deliver those products when they deliver their nut order card products. On the convenience, a system will send that and the customer will pay for shipping. So if you use the item to the right, the girl delivered, you have to coordinate for the pickup and delivery. On the right, if you choose convenience, it could be shipped directly, but the customer pays for shipping. But remember, in both cases, customer's paying by credit card, and if you place an order on a nut order card, like I mentioned earlier, remember the customer has to pay up front. So that's the girl experience. There are multiple ways to sell product: in person online, and online that gets delivered in person, or online it gets shipped, whether it's a magazine or a nut and chocolate item. Now what we're also going to do is we're going to talk about your volunteer access, because the volunteer level access is where all the volunteers log in. And one of the comments we got last year, for those of you that participated, was, we don't like the shoe choices. The shoe choices are not as good as the girls. There was comments that we didn't like the khaki pants and we didn't have any other choices and we didn't like that. And then we had some volunteers who were annoyed who said, hey, there's no white hair and no gray hair. As you can see, there is now white hair, there is now gray hair for all of the volunteers that need that. We also have all the same shoe choices that the girls have. And by the way, in addition to khaki pants, we have a khaki skirt and we also have jeans so that all of the volunteers can represent themselves and get in on the fun. Now, I'm here to tell you that I think the volunteers are just a bunch of big kids because they may like this program even better than the girls do. So this is an exciting way for you to get in on the fun and then tell the girls, you want to check out my avatar, make sure you log in. First thing that will happen is you will get an email. The email will give you a little link that you will then go create your password. If you participated last year, you'll get a different email. That email will say, if you participated last year, click here to update your password or log in. And if you've never done this before, we will send you a link that looks like this. You will create a password, and then you'll be able to log into the system. You can get to this login page via the email. You can also get to the login page via the volunteer button that I showed you earlier. Once you get logged in, the first thing that we'll do is we will show you a troop training video. That troop training video is about 6 minutes long. It will tell you everything your troop needs to do in the system. So basically, it will go through all the icons. It will show you how to click on them and find your delivery tickets and show you how to find the girl delivered reports, and it'll show you how to create your avatar and all that cool stuff. So we have a very simple training video. Once the video ends, you'll click continue. Then that video will be available at any point during the campaign for you to check out. Once you watch the video, you'll be able to get started. You'll be able to create your avatar. You'll be able to upload a video if you want the girls to get together and create a video that will show for them. You'll be able to enter or manage your in-person paper orders to see that the girls are entering them in the system and then having access to it once the girls are completed entering them. And then you could view all your reports. So you'll have access to all the information and all the reports necessary in the program. So once you log in, you'll land on a landing page dashboard that looks like this. It will have all of your sales. It'll have all of the sales, the number of avatars created, the number of emails sent. It will tell you how you did in the program. You have the ability to create your avatar. And then at the bottom, we'll have all kinds of things you can do. So there'll be a place where you can enter your paper orders. You can see all the girls' reward, all the girls that earn rewards are listed there. You can see all the girls that are in their personalized patches. You can click on reports. And you'll notice that last year you used to click on something called TNOS. And when you did that, it took you into the system, and then you had to figure out where you needed to go next. This year, we'll have all the icons. So there's your delivery ticket icon, your delivery site icon. You'll be able to click on the financials, the payment. All the things that you needed to do in that system will be listed and located for you right there to make it nice and easy for you to find. You can also send a message to the girls. The message to the girls that you send have the ability to send a note to all the participants in the program if you want to let them know how things are going, or you want to let them know, encourage them, or if you want them to have success. You have the ability to click on participant and create an announcement, and you can send them a message at any time and let them know how they're doing in the program. The direct link to TNOS looks like this. So you have reports, you have delivery tickets, delivery sites, you have the financials, which will tell you how much troop proceeds you've earned, and you can record your payments in that system too. No longer do you have to go in and figure it out. You'll just click on the icon. And remember, the video that we show you will tell you about all of those icons. So the video will explain how that works. So you don't need to worry about it too much. You just follow the instructions, click on these, and it will take you to all of the locations you need to go in the NUT administration site. Entering your in-person NUT order cards, remember the parents are going to do this first. Once the parents do this, then they'll get locked out. Then if there's any additional girls that you need to enter, one, if you need to edit anyone, click on the pencil, and you can go in and adjust their order. If a girl's name is missing from the list, you can add her in right here. And if you need to enter anybody or add anybody, you can very easily do so. This is a very simple way to enter the paper orders. Remember, parents go first, they get locked out, then you go, and then the service units will be able to check and help you out if you haven't gotten an order in or an order shows up really late. Reports, again, you can click on the girl, you can look at their magazines, who bought from them, you can look at their NUT reports. And if you look all the way to the right on the top, there's a report called Online NUTs Girl Delivered Report. And the Online NUT Girl Delivered Report is all those promises that people paid for online, but the girls need to deliver. That is available in the system. You as a troop person, troop leader, or troop product manager can get that, and you can send it to the parents. Plus, we will email it to the parents once that portion of the program is over. So it'll get emailed to the parents. We will have you have access to it, the parents have access to it, the council has access to it, So that report is accessible on every level. So if anybody's looking for it, we can give them that information. The troop reports, you'll notice that by clicking on a girl's name, you can see exactly who bought, what they bought, and all of the information listed, and you can get all the way down to the customer and see what Uncle Mike bought. So that's how simple the online portion of the troop level is. You'll log in, you'll watch the video, you'll be able to do all of the things I mentioned. Follow that instructional video, and remember, you can always go back and watch that video later on if there's anything you need a refresher on. So the last thing I'll be sharing with you tonight is that we got so much interest in that personalized patch this past year, and so many people were so excited about it that we said, what could be better than one personalized patch? We all joked and said, two personalized patches. So this year, we're going to offer two personalized patches. One you can get exclusively by participating in the fall, as I mentioned before. The other one you can get by participating in both the fall and the cookie program. And since the cookie program this year has 100 years of Girl Scouts selling cookies, we thought what would be better than to create our second patch and make it for online participation, but make it the coolest patch you've ever seen. So this year, the girls will be able to earn a second personalized patch. It will have their name on it. It will have 100 years of Girl Scouts selling cookies. It will say the Girl Scouts of Historic Georgia, so it'll have a council name, girl's name. It'll reference cookies. It'll have cookie boxes on it. And all you have to do to get this is very simple. It's actually the best way to earn it in any Girl Scout council we work. All you have to do is participate online in both programs. So you have to send 15 emails in the fall and create your avatar. Why do we need you to create your avatar? Because if you don't create your avatar, we cannot get you the patch because the patch has your avatar on it. So in the fall, you create your avatar and you send 15 emails. And if you also send 15 emails in the digital cookie program when that starts in 2017, so 15 emails in fall and 15 emails in the digital cookie, if you just send 15 emails in both, you will get the patch at the end of the cookie program. So this is a second patch. It's so cool. 15 emails in both programs. Create your avatar in the fall. It's a very simple way to get participation in both programs. So as a reminder, in order to earn the fall patch, you have to create your avatar and send 15 emails. And then to get the fall, if you look to the left, you have to sell 6 magazines and 24 nut items. If you meet that criteria, you'll get the one on the left. If you also send 15 emails in the digital cookie program, you will get the patch on the right. So you can earn both patches if you create your avatar and send 15 emails in the fall, sell 6 magazines and 24 nut and chocolate items, and also send 15 emails in the digital cookie program. You will have the ability to earn both patches. Now, before I end, I want to remind everybody a number of things. One, girls have multiple ways to participate in person and online. The online has multiple options for the customer, so give the customer, make sure the girls take the opportunity to do both. We find that girls who send emails and sell things from their nut order card get the best results. We really need your help in the patch program because this patch on the right is going to be, you can only earn it if you participate in both fall and cookies. If you don't participate in the fall, you will not have the ability to do this in the cookie program. So please get the word out because we know that parents and troop leaders are going to say things like, oh, I didn't know about it. So please help us by getting the word out. We put it on the flyer. We put it on the nut order card. We put it in all those places. But tell people about it because the girls seem to love this patch. And because it's 100 years of Girl Scouts selling cookies and raising money, it's a very exciting patch to earn. Last but not least, I want to make sure I say an additional thank you, that as I start with a thank you and I always try to end with a thank you. It has been a remarkable year working with your council and the success. I cannot wait to see this year's program. I have a strong suspicion that the cool new personalized patches are going to be very exciting. I'm going to turn it over to Christy, and she's going to handle some dates and some specifics to the council, and then we'll address some questions at the end. And thank you again for taking the time to participate in the program.
Okay, thank you, Mike. I'm opening up the presentation now. It should be loading. There we go. Okay, so to talk to you a little bit about form, and we do have some questions, so don't go anywhere. We'll be coming back to you for some of those. but I want to hear a big hoop and holler from my people here in Athens because all of our forms are online this year. All right, I hear them. we heard y'all, and we wanted to make sure that this was easier, especially with the service areas going larger. We wanted to make it easier for you to be able to get those forms. So all of the forms have gone online. So when you're finished with your stuff, you'll send it over to the service area person by email. Just say, I've completed everything. They'll send us an email saying everything's been completed, and then we'll be done. So let's go over the forms just a little bit so that you can see them. The forms that are online this year are the parent permission form, the ACH form, the troop-to-troop patch form, and the product manager agreement form. I have somebody who is unmuted. Okay, sorry, I just heard some background noise, and I know sometimes that gets a little hard to hear when you have all that. So you can find all of these, except for the troop-to-troop patch form, at this point, at gshg.org and on our cookie page, which is right there. So if you go to our Cookies Plus page, to the Fall Product Program, you go down, and this gives you our calendar, gives you the training dates, but it also gives you those forms. So you've got them right there ready to go. Like I said, the troop-to-troop is being added tomorrow, so you'll be able to see it then, but all of them are available before the beginning of the sale. The ACH form, many of you have already filled it out. Yes, it is online. It is for people who are returning or that we do have their information. If we happen to not have your banking information online, we will, in our office, we will contact you to get a voided check or to get that banking information. But if you've done it before, then chances are we've got all that information and you just have to fill it out online. So it's quick and simple and to the point. The parent permission form. This is filled out by all the parents. What we ask that you do, because they can fill it out, it goes to us, we have it, but the troop leaders don't necessarily know that they filled it out. You get a confirmation email. Have them forward you that confirmation email that allows you to know that they have completed that parent permission form. We also have options to where you can contact your council product sale person because we will have a list of everybody that has turned it in by troop and we can give you those names also. But it'll be a lot quicker for you if you just have them forward you that email that they get. The product manager agreement. We have these every year. You'll go through and you'll fill it out. If you are a service area or district person, you can click both. If you are with a troop only, just click the troop. But if you're doing it for both, you can do that. You only have to fill out one form. And then our troop-to-troop order form. This is our gift of caring or caring and sharing. They call it something different in their program, Mike and M, I think it's caring, sharing, but we call it troop to troop. That's where we send nuts and candies overseas to the soldiers. Now, it must be sent overseas in order to earn the troop to troop patch. There must be 12 units of nuts and candy. You can send them yourself as a troop, or we can send them virtually. If you do send them, you have to attach the declarations, copy of the declarations form from the post office, and it has to be turned in by November 23rd. It states that clearly on the troop-to-troop order form. You can actually fill this out for all of your girls. Now, if you have more than, I believe it's 12 girls, you might have to fill the form out twice, but you can do that. That's not a problem, but it just lets us go up to 12 girls. Okay. And again, they are located on our website, easy to find, right there on the Fall Products under Cookies Plus. Now, they're also in your book, and if you don't know where they are and you can't find them, you can get them from your product sales manager. Now, to go over just a few little important dates, order taking begins on October 1st. So basically, we're going the full month of October, October 1st through October 31st. So the girls, you got up until, the 30th, get them their stuff. They'll start taking orders on the 1st. October 5th, we need you to make sure that you go into the TNOS system or the M2 system and verify that your information is correct so that we have your phone number and any addresses and everything there in case we need to send you something or give you a call about any missing information. October 31st is when the order taking ends. Remember, the parents are going to enter the girls' paper orders and make the reward choices for you. Everything is online, so you won't need their order card. They can, if by chance they don't get it in there, they can text you what they want. They can, because they don't have to turn in other stuff to you. They don't have to turn in the paper cards to you. They can just text you their order because it's their responsibility to make sure they've got what they need and they have the money for it. If the money does not match what they're giving you to order, remember, you don't place the order. It is a pay up front. November 1st at midnight, the troops just make sure that everything looks correct and that there's not 500 of something in there where it should be 5. If you don't have the money for it, then you don't place that order. The deposits should go into your bank account at that point. And then November 2nd at noon, you'll shoot an email over to your service area person, let them know you're done. November 2nd at noon, the service area will say, okay, I looked through them. There's not one that looks really bad, because you're just looking to make sure that there's nothing that stands out as, oh, this can't be right. You'll send over a email to the council person and let us know that you're completely done. We will have already had all of your paperwork and everything because you've done it online and it comes directly to us. The 10th, you'll start seeing the ACH postings in your account, so that's when we start taking the money out. November 14th through the 16th, that's when the products are delivered to the service unit, separated by troop, and then the troops get them and deliver them to their customers. That way you have them before Thanksgiving holiday. And November 23rd, like I said, is the deadline for the troop-to-troop patch order forms. And the week after the 14th is probably when the incentives are going to come in, and they'll come to the service unit also. We wanted to make sure that we've got the products delivered to you before Thanksgiving.